Again?
Welcome everyone. I got a parking ticket once again. I was out and about, and this is going to transition to a potential use case that I see within the Cardano blockchain or within blockchain in general. And the reason why I'm thinking about this is because of the recent partnerships with Cardano and things that I think could make sense, or blockchain applications that can make sense in the future. I was out and about, I was eating at a restaurant, I used one of those mobile parking apps, I don't know if it was Go Parking or Park Mobile, one of the two. I use them all the time, and I had around 30 minutes left when I returned to my vehicle, and I see a parking ticket on the dashboard. It infuriated me because I paid for it. I don't try to dodge the parking, because those parking meters, the parking attendants, they're quick to either tow your car or put a parking violation ticket on your vehicle. So I used the app, and even though I used the app and there was time left and the license plate was correct, all the information was correct, I still got a parking ticket. And I feel as though that the people handing out the parking tickets, maybe they make commission off of each car that they issue a ticket or a violation to, and it's up to you to start fighting it back with the city that you're in. But if you're in a random city or you're out and about and you don't visit that city, who wants to spend time fighting a parking ticket? Because sometimes you have to call, or you have to show up, or you have to defend yourself. La-di-da. So the reason why I'm making this video today is because I see a potential use case for using Cardano or any blockchain within this type of market. We've seen with the new Balance partnership that you can put assets on the blockchain. In this case, it's shoes. What if we transition that? What if we put actual vehicles or license plates on the blockchain? So when you're using these parking services, you can go up to whatever zone that you're in. You scan that normal QR code for the app, but this connects to the blockchain. Your license plate or your vehicle is already registered to the blockchain as an asset. And all of a sudden you just scan it and the time starts. And maybe once you return back to that zone, maybe it uses some sort of GPS within your phone and it tells you, do you want to end your parking trip? And you can end it right there. And it can consume the amount of ADA or the amount of USD or the number of euros or yen, whatever currency that you're using, and it could be to the minute. And there's no parking attendant that could tell you that you didn't pay for the service, because that asset is registered on an immutable blockchain and there's no tampering with it. So if it's there, it's there. And since the asset is physically on the blockchain, whatever parking attendant is there, they can verify those records with 150% accuracy, because the asset will forever live on that blockchain. So that would be a very cool use case. Think about that. You go out to eat, or you're going out and have a good time. You're spending a few hours. You have your ADA wallet, or you have your Yoroi, or you have your Daedalus, or you don't even need to have your wallet. You have whatever app, Cardano parking app. You drive up, you park, you scan the QR code where your meter is, and all of a sudden the clock starts ticking and you charge per minute or per second. It's these microtransactions that would be wonderful to use. So even if you're paying a few dollars for, I don't know, an hour of parking, it would be charged for that hour of parking, and it would be on an immutable ledger. And when you return back to that parking spot, you can cancel. And any parking attendant that's looking at your car, or parking violator that's looking to give you a ticket, they can just check the records. They can double check, they can triple check. It's on an immutable ledger. So I think that would be a wonderful use case. And I think that moving forward, in order to have this sort of mass adoption within Cardano, the way the system and the protocol is structured, we're going to have to make sure that we have as many micro transaction friendly apps and dApps and business models as possible, because at the end of the day, the number of transactions per epoch directly correlates with the staking rewards that everyone receives within a 5-day period. So the higher the number of transactions, the greater the rewards, and the greater the utility, the easier the road to mass adoption. And I think that we're going to have to make sure that we have all these microtransactions. And it's not necessarily about having high dollar value amounts or high ADA value amounts, but just having a lot of these little repeat transactions happening all the time. And this is what's going to allow people to say, wow, Cardano is being utilized. Let me put my money here. Let me bring some new investment here. Let me put my mutual fund here. Let me put my IRA here. Let me put my whatever investment vehicle you want to put on Cardano, or what money you want to put on Cardano. You feel encouraged to do so because of the number of transactions, because of the utility. So utility, these microtransactions are going to allow new businesses to thrive, and it's going to be great. So let me know what you think. I think that this would be a great business model. I mean, it could be scaled to whatever, but this idea of me receiving a parking ticket or whatever parking violation when I know I paid, and you just have to kind of fight the system, and you have to spend time and money to prove yourself innocent, even though you were innocent. It's archaic. It's outdated. There needs to be a better business model behind this. So I'm all for that, and let's see what ideas you have, and let me know if this is a good idea, and until the next video. All right, and remember, sign up on stakecardano.io. This is our staking pool. This is the premier staking pool experience for Cardano. We're going to send out some email updates soon. We're still trying to find out some more information about when the snapshot date is. There was also a release about what wallets are snapshot ready from IOHK. Paper wallets will be snapshot friendly. It's just the hardware wallets that won't be. So Yodoi, Daedalus, paper wallets, you're good to go. I may link it down below. So let me know what you think, and have a great weekend. Thanks, everyone.